Explosions are awesome. We all love to have a little gander at explosive carnage, whether it's on a movie screen or in real life. I've been lucky enough to get to film a bunch of controlled explosions, and I can tell you, blowing random stuff up never gets old. But I wanted to ask, why is that? Why do we get such a thrill out of something so destructive and potentially deadly? The first explosive to be invented was black powder, and it's believed that that was invented in China around the 10th century. And at the time, black powder was only used for fireworks, which is awesome. Within a few hundred years, this explosive was found all around the world, and then of course, it didn't take very long for it to become weaponized, which is not so awesome. Black powder is still used in a lot of fuse wires today, and it remained the explosive standard until the 1800s when Alfred Nobel developed dynamite. Nobel wanted to find a way to make the notoriously volatile nitroglycerin a profitable commercial product. And now, nitroglycerin is extremely sensitive to heat and shock. Nobel was unlucky enough to get treated to a display of this deadly power when his factory exploded in 1864, killing several, including one of his brothers. Whereas this probably would have put most people off, Nobel carried on tinkering until he found a type of porous earth called Kieselgur. I'm not too sure, I think it's a German word. This porous rock absorbed nitroglycerin and could be shaped into sticks. So, in 1867, we got dynamite, a much more stable form of nitroglycerin explosive. And yes, Alfred Nobel is that guy who created the Nobel Peace Prize, which seems a bit odd considering he spent his entire life developing explosives and munitions. That leads us on to the question, why do we like explosions so much when we know they're so dangerous? So apparently the simple answer is that they're scary. When we're scared, we go into fight or flight mode, which dumps a bunch of endorphins and dopamine into our body, which we usually use for either smashing someone up or running for it. But if we're seeing something scary, but we know we're safe, like a controlled explosion from a distance, those chemicals swirl around in our body and create an opioid-like sense of euphoria. Also, surviving an anxiety-racking experience can leave you with an incredible feeling of self-satisfaction. This is what leads people to seek out extreme thrills. New Zealander AJ Hackett popularized bungee jumping by illegally diving off the Eiffel Tower in 1987. He got arrested for that, of course. But can you imagine his first jump? He was only the second person to develop bungee jumping properly, and he was an amateur and he made his own cord. He couldn't have known for sure that it was going to be safe. But I'm glad he did that first jump, because I've bungee jumped and it is amazing. As I jumped from the platform, I tried to scream, but the air caught in my throat. The grassy ground rushed up towards me to smash me into oblivion, and then the bungee caught me, and I was safe, and the exhilaration I felt was incredible. So that's why we find explosions exciting, but that's kind of the problem, because explosions and explosives are never 100% safe, and of course they've been weaponized a tiny bit. So I wanted to know what actually happens to your body if you're unlucky enough to be standing too close to an explosion. And first off, I think we need to understand what an explosion actually is. It's often a solid turning to a gas extremely quickly and massively expanding in volume. In the case of black powder, you've got saltpeter, which is potassium nitrate, charcoal and sulfur. When you light it, the sulfur catches first, having the lowest ignition point, which then sets fire to the charcoal and the potassium nitrate. The potassium nitrate is stuffed full of oxygen, which causes the fire to burn extremely quickly. In a split second, it turns into ash, carbon dioxide, and nitrogen gas. It takes an extremely small amount of energy to get this chemical reaction going. And once it does, the gases expand to 200 times the size of the black powder almost instantaneously. Meaning a pile of black powder this big will lead to an explosion this big. And this is considered a low explosive. So to see what this ball of hot expanding gas can do to a person, I'm gonna do a little experiment. So here I have a charge strapped to my desk here, and I've got a piece of paper suspended. I'm gonna see what's gonna happen to that paper when I set this sucker off. And I'm gonna run and hide in my house. So here we go. I'm excited to see how this is going to turn out. Oh! So let's go and see if that's done the damage. Let's have a look at this. Look at that.
It's blasted a hole straight through it. Oh, I can smell the sulfur. Imagine if that was your eardrum.
So you can see that the shockwave absolutely decimated the paper. And if you look closely at the slow-mo, you can see that the energy from the explosion, first of all, it surges forwards and blasts through the paper, and then some of it is actually reflected back. And if you were standing close enough to an explosion big enough, the pressure of the blast wave could cause you some serious problems. It can rupture your eardrums or even crush your chest to the point that it causes a pulmonary contusion. You might survive the initial explosion only to die from the damage to your lungs. But that isn't the most common cause of death from explosions. So a bomb is an explosive placed inside a hard shell that's designed to shatter when the charge goes off. So what I've done is I've taken one of my little charges and I've put it in this boltwood box here. And I've got my glamorous test dummy here, who's going to be a replica human, to see what happens to her when this bomb goes off. And I'm actually really excited to see what happens. So here we go. So let's see if this works. Taking a close look at our crash test dummy, you can see that there are burn marks all over her clothes, so she was definitely struck by debris. And now, this bomb, the shell was only made out of balsa wood. I didn't really want to completely destroy my crash test dummy. I'm not completely evil. But if this was a real bomb, the explosion would have sent fragments of metal flying everywhere, and that's what makes bombs so deadly. This metal would have become shrapnel, tiny projectiles, which can really f*** a person up. Shrapnel can break bones, shred organs, and if it strikes you on the head, it can shatter your skull and cause your brain to hemorrhage.
And that's why you should never play with fireworks, which is a lesson that our family and I discovered a little bit too late. They decided to mix black powder with a gender reveal party. They placed black powder in a tube that was meant to fire blue sparkles into the air, but instead they accidentally created a pipe bomb, and when it went off, a woman 15 meters away was killed by a piece of flying metal. And that piece of metal carried on flying for another 130 meters. So if you learn anything from this video, it's probably don't bring explosives to a family party. If you want to see some more killer facts, then don't forget to subscribe to see the newest bad science videos first. And if you have an idea for a topic for me to cover, please comment below. And until next time, just don't blow yourself up.